I just have to make a clear announcement that this isn't a paid endorsement for Sega! Hey everybody, welcome to my channel, Stinky V, and I got some gaming news. So yesterday I discussed about the Game Gear Micro being Sega's announcement, but clearly it was just to throw people off, and we all know the announcement now being Sega's Arcade Fox service. I'm late to really upload a video and report this, but I didn't see any point to rush and go on YouTube and upload a video on this. But anyway, to get back to the announcement, if you guys already don't know about this, it's the Sega Arcade Fox service. And what it is it's a cloud gaming service. It's going to probably compete with the Google Stadia's in Japan. I assume it's in Japan and it's worldwide. And what it is it uses arcade cabinets to pretty much stream gameplay from people's houses using arcade machines. So instead of using dedicated servers, they're using their actual arcade CPUs and GPUs. What's really interesting about this is, instead of Sega making arcade machines in the future to just play at an arcade, their new arcade machines in the future will have more versatility. Arcade gaming in Japan has had a huge presence for decades, further beyond any other country. Most countries in terms of actual arcades don't have that many or any dedicated arcades, just like in Japan at all. Arcades in the past 10 years have been declining in Japan, so this move substantially keeps arcade machine businesses more relevant and viable. It's a very smart idea from Sega if cloud gaming is to become a thing, with other companies like Google with Stadia and Netflix discussing having full motion video games as streaming services. I personally think this is great for arcades in Japan to modernize, and I believe if I ever buy into a cloud gaming service, this would be a good way to do it. You're using existing machines, and they're dedicated to gaming, unlike Google servers with Google Stadia. Sega is a real gaming company, unlike Google, and those arcade machines are allowing for arcade manufacturers to still create new arcade machines, given how the console industry has overtaken them over the past 30 years. Playing an arcade is definitely a different experience. It's antiquated, yes, in a way, but you get a premium gaming experience, I would say, with the best sound and best visuals with a different scenery from your home. This allows also for people who love specific arcade games that don't get console ports to be experienced. So here's a picture of me from 2013 at one of the biggest arcades called Sega Joy Bullis in Tokyo. It's in like the Odaiba area. So I waited a long time in line to try out this arcade version of Initial D inside a real car modified to play the game. How cool is that? This arcade was completely modified to provide feedback with the movement in the vehicle, so it wasn't just an arcade. It was more of a drifting simulator, I would say. Some arcade experiences just can't be replicated on the game console, so giving people the option to even demo an arcade before trying it in person would definitely revolutionize the arcade industry. I know some console ports already do that, but this would be a real-time demo of an arcade machine you'd get, unlike a console port. This isn't the news that Famitsu really made it seem out to be. It definitely is an industry-changing move and exciting from an arcade owner's and operator's perspective in Japan. Arcade owners and operators aren't just limited to having their arcade machines in the future to being played during after hours, but if the arcades themselves are idling, then they could probably be played remotely from home users. It's also pushing for the arcade business to be a 24-hour operation with potential increased revenue. This is fascinating in terms of foreigners who want to go to Japan but can't. They want to try the Japanese arcade machines. With the Sega Fog service, you'd be able to try arcade games you wouldn't be able to on the home console. If you've ever been to Japan, you get it. You understand it from seeing arcades there and experiencing them firsthand. If not, I recommend to any of my subscribers to think about visiting Japan and experiencing what a premium arcade gaming experience is like. Will this be an arcade renaissance created by Sega? Only time will tell.